Yeah. من فيوت من مبشير من بابن في مائف قواب قنوتي إن قوت إفز ما رقوت إن جي إفنوتي فيوت بي بانتوكراتور
آمين
إفز ما رقوت إن جي بفمونو جنيس إن شيري إيسوس بإخريستوس بنشويس
Tiros moe choi, maro es moro fingenile ostiro, che bevna e tagure heri bon otimes minte choi shop shine amen. Alleluia.
وأن يحفظ لنا حياة
حياه وقيام ابينا الاسقف المكرم الانبا يوسف، واجعلنا مستحقين لشتى اسرى مقدسه مباركه لمغفره خطايانا.
All the work of Satan, the counsel of wicked men, and the rising up of enemies hidden and manifest, take them away from us and from all your people, and from this table, and from this your holy place. But those things which are good and profitable do provide for us, for it is you who have given us the authority to tread on serpents and scorpions and upon all the power of the enemy.
Patriarch Saint Severus, our teacher Dioscorus, Saint Athanasius the Apostolic, Saint Peter the Holy Martyr and the Archpriest, Saint John Chrysostom, Saint Cyril, Saint Basil, Saint Gregory, from the mouth 318 Assembly of Nicaea, 105 at Constantinople, 200 at Ephesus, and from my own mouth being the least, for bliss and full of glory is your holy name, O Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever and unto the age of ages. Amen.
Thank you. وخوف ورعدة كثيرة، وكلامي وكرازتي لم يكون بإقناع بكلام حكمة بشرية بل ببرهان الروح والقوة، لكي لا يكون إيمانكم بحكمة الناس بل بقوة الله، لكننا نتكلم بحكمة بين الكاملين، بحكمة ليست من هذا الدهر ولا بحكمة رؤساء هذا الدهر الذين يبطلون، بل ننطق بحكمة الله في سر، الحكمة المكتومة التي سبق الله فعينها قبل الظهور لمجدنا، التي لم يعرفها أحدا من رؤساء هذا الدهر، لأنهم لو عرفوها لما صلبوا رب المجد، بل كما هو مكتوب: ما لم ترى عين ولم تسمع به أذن ولم يخطر على قلب بشر ما أعده الله للذين يحبونه. فأعلنها الله لنا نحن بالروح، لأن الروح يفحص كل شيء حتى أعماق الله، لأنه من من الناس يعرف أمور الإنسان إلا روح الإنسان الساكن فيه، هكذا أيضا أمور الله لا يعرفها أحدا إلا روح الله. ونحن لم نأخذ روح العالم بل الروح الذي من الله، لنعرف الأشياء الموهوبة لنا من الله، هذه التي نتكلم بها أيضا، ليس بتعاليم أقوال بشرية بل بتعاليم الروح. مقارنين الروحيات بالروحيات، لكن الإنسان النفساني لا يقبل مال روح الله لأنه عنده جهالة، ولا يقدر أن يعرفه لأنه حكم فيه روحيا. وأما الروحاني فسيحكم في كل شيء وهو لا يحكم فيه من أحد، لأنه من عرف فكر الرب أو من يمكنه أن يعلمه. وأما نحن فلنا فكر المسيح. نعمة الله الآن فلتحل على أرواحنا يا أبائي وأخوتي. أمين.
The Catholic Epistle from the first epistle of our teacher Saint Peter. His blessing with us all. Amen, my beloved. Therefore, gird up the loins of your mind. Be sober and rest your hope fully upon the grace that is to be brought to you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. As obedient children, not conforming yourselves to the former lusts, as in your ignorance, but he who called you is holy. You also be holy in all your conduct, because it is written, "Be holy, for I am holy." And if you call on the Father, who without partiality judges according to each one's work, conduct yourselves throughout the time of your sojourning here in fear, knowing that you were not redeemed with the corruptible things, like silver or gold, from your aimless conduct received by tradition from your fathers, but with the precious blood of Christ, as of a lamb without blemish and without spot. He indeed was foreordained before the fountain of the world, but was manifested in these last times for you, who through him believe in God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory, so that your faith and hope are in God. Do not love the world nor the things which are in the world. The worship pass away and all its desires, but he who does the will of God shall abide forever. Amen.
وأما شاول فكان يزداد قوة وكان يزعج اليهود الساكنين في دمشق مبينا لهم ان هذا هو المسيح. ولما تمت ايام كثيره تشاور اليهود ليقتلوه، فاعلموا شاول بمشورتهم وكانوا يحرسون الابواب نهارا وليلا ليقتلوه. فاخذه التلاميذ ليلا وانزلوه من السور في سل، ولما جاء شاول الى اورشليم حاول ان يلتصق بالتلاميذ، وكانوا جميعا يخافون منه غير مصدقين انه تلميذ. فاخذه برنابا واحضره الى الرسل وحدثهم كيف ابصر الرب في الطريق وانه كلمه وكيف ظاهر في دمشق باسم يسوع. فكان معهم يدخل في اورشليم ويخرج ويجاهر باسم الرب يسوع، وكان يخاطب ويباحث اليونانيين. اما هم فارادوا ان يرفعوا ايديهم عليه ليقتلوه، فلما علم الاخوه احضروه وارسلوه الى طرسوس. واما الكنيسه في كل اليهوديه والجليل والسامره فكان لها سلام، وكانت تبنى وتسير في خوف الرب وبتعزيه الروح القدس كانت تتكاثر. لم تزل كلمه الرب تنمو وتكسر وتعتز وتثبت في هذه البيعه المقدسه. وكل بيعه يا ابائي واخواتي امين.
The acts of our fathers apostles in their holy person be with us all, amen. But so increase all the more in strength and confounded the Jews who dwelt in Damascus, proving that this Jesus is the Christ. Now after many days were passed, and Jews plotted to kill him, but their plot became known to Saul, and they watched the gates day and night to kill him. Then the disciples took him by night and led him down through the wall in a large basket. And when Saul had come to Jerusalem, he tried to join the disciples, but they were all afraid of him and did not believe that he was a disciple. But Barnabas took him and brought him to the apostles, and he declared to them how he had seen the Lord on the road, and that he had spoken to him, and how he had preached boldly at Damascus in the name of Jesus. So he was with them at Jerusalem, coming in and going out, and he spoke boldly in the name of the Lord Jesus and disputed against the Hellenists. But they attempted to kill him. When the brethren found out, they brought him down to Caesarea and sent him out to Tarsus. Then the churches throughout all Judea, Galilee, and Samaria had peace and were edified. And walking in the fear of the Lord and in comfort of the Holy Spirit, they were multiplied. The word of the Lord shall grow, multiply, and be mighty, and be confirmed in the Holy Church of God. Amen.
The tender mercies of our merciful Lord.
On this day of the year 512 AD, the righteous father of St. Athanasius II, 28th patriarch of the see of St. Mark, departed. His father was the steward of the churches of Alexandria. When the holy father, Apophyter III, departed, the bishops, elders, and people agreed to ordain him patriarch for what was known of his orthodox faith and knowledge. He was a pious man filled with the Holy Spirit and faith. When he became patriarch, he shepherded the flock of the Lord Christ exceedingly well, and he protected them from the snatching wolves of his teachings and prayers, with his teachings and prayers. He sat on the episcopal throne for 3 years and 9 months, then departed in peace. May his prayers be with us. Amen. On this day also is the commemoration of the martyrdom of Saint Meditina the Virgin. Also today we commemorate the departure of Saint Theophesta. She was married and had a son. Her husband died while she was still young. She took it upon herself to become a nun. She started to practice the spiritual life. She persisted in fasting and continual prayers and worshiping day and night. She went to the Holy Father, Papa Macarius, Bishop of Nicaeus. She bowed to him, took his blessings. Then she asked him to pray on her and put on her the garb of monasticism. The bishop advised her to try for a year, and he promised her that he would put on her the garb of monasticism after that year. She went to her house and shut herself in a small room. She closed its doors and made a small opening in it. Her son, who was then 12 years old, was taking care of her needs. She embarked in strenuous worships with asceticism and devotion. The year elapsed, and the bishop had forgotten that he had promised the saint that he would put on her the garb of monasticism. He saw her in his sleep in a shining figure, telling him, "My father, how did you forget me till now? And I am passing away tonight." The father, the bishop, saw that as if he was awake. He prayed on her the prayer for ordaining monks and put on her the garb of monasticism. When he did not find a kanasua, cover of the head, he took off his own and put it on her head. Then he put on her the holy scheme. He asked his disciple for another kanasua and put it on it. She had a silver cross in her hand, which she gave to him, saying, "Accept this from your disciple." And it was said that when he awakened, he found the cross in his hand, and he looked attentively at the cross, which was beautifully made. He was amazed and glorified God. Early in the morning, he went with his disciple to the house of this blessed woman. Her son received him crying with tears. When he asked him why he was crying, he replied, saying, "My mother called me in the middle of the night and bid me farewell and told me, whatever the bishop tells you, do and do not break it. I will depart this night to go to the Lord Christ. She prayed over me and advised me, saying, keep all that I commanded you and do not disobey our father, the bishop, and here now I am in your hands." The bishop came to where the saint was laying and knocked on the door, but she did not answer. He said, "This blessed saint had departed indeed." And he ordered his disciple to open the door. When the bishop entered, he found that she had given up her soul. She had on the scheme that he had put on her in his vision, and also the kanasua that he had on. His eyes were filled with tears. He praised and glorified God, who works out the satisfaction of his saints. The bishop shrouded her, as was the habit of the monks, and called the priests, who carried her to the holy church and prayed over her with great honor. There was in the city a paralytic, infidel man suffering from evil spirit. When he heard the chanting of the priests, he asked his people to carry him and take him where the body of the saint was. When they brought him to the church, he drew near to the holy body with faith, and he was cured instantly. The devil came out of him, and he became well. And he and his people believed in the Lord Christ, and the bishop baptized them. And everyone who had a disease or a deformity would come to the church and touch the holy body and would be healed immediately. When the governor heard about these wonders, he and most of the city believed in the Lord Christ. He came to the church, carried the body, and buried it with honor. Glory be to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and His Father, and His Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
And holy apostles, many prophets and righteous men have desired to see the things which you see and have not seen them, and to hear the things which you hear and have not heard them. But as for you, blessed are your eyes, for they see, and your ears, for they hear. May we be worthy to hear and to act according to your holy gospel through the prayers of your saints.
Lord, have
also within us to remember them in our supplications and prayers which we offer up unto you, Lord our God. Those who have already fallen asleep, repose them. Those who are sick, heal them. For you are the life of us all, the salvation of us all, the hope of us all, the healing of us all, and the resurrection of us all.
Blessed be my God, and let the God of my salvation be exalted. Therefore will I confess to you, O Lord, among the Gentiles, and sing to your name, Alleluia. Let them exalt him in the church of his people, and praise him in the seat of the elders, for he has made the family like a flock of sheep. The upright shall see it and rejoice. The Lord has sworn and will have no regrets. You are a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. The Lord is at your right hand. Our Father, the Bishop of Yosef, may the Lord keep your life up.
بمحبة عايز انبه تنبيه، تفضل استريح، تفضل كله.